you go back a couple of weeks before the site was picked, I do write for a blog, I do write for a website, and I picked a very similar site where I just missed out one.
Okay.
I had 14 guys which I had picked, they're pretty much in the site. And this was picked before the team was actually picked by the selectors.
Okay.
So I had picked in Dinesh Karthik for Shami. Eventually, Karthik has come in place of Manish Pandey.
Yeah.
But anyways, the point, the answer to your question is that good side, pretty much the side I have picked, but again, a little bit of a worry in the sense that a lot of these guys are aging, a lot of our players aren't in the peak form.
Okay.
UV, I don't know, still a very good player.
Okay.
And if you go back to his last ODI season, he's got 100 against England. So you can't really drop him, and he's someone who's done well.
Okay.
But is he still there? Does he still have it? He's been a great player. I'm not even debating that. I'm not even going there. But does he still have it?
Okay.
That's one. Rahane not batting at his best.
Okay.
Rohit Sharma coming out of a 6-month layoff.
Yeah.
Hasn't had the greatest IPL, hasn't had the best of mix. Again, a good player. Dhoni doesn't look the same. His glove work is still the best.
Yeah.
His glove work is still impeccable. The batting isn't the same. But again, he's got 100 in the last series against England. So, but small things like that. Shami isn't really bowling at his peak.
Okay.
He's again coming off an injury.
Yeah.
IPL was just a starting point again. He looks a bit rusty to me. Bhuvi is brilliant.
Okay.
Bumrah is brilliant. Ravi Jadeja, spin, again a bit of a worry. So there are things that need to be looked into. Kohli got at the peakest of form.
Yeah.
But again, you never know with that guy. He's a crazy guy.
Yeah.
He's capable of stepping it up
a bit
like that. So on paper, great side. On form, a bit of a worry. Go with Dhawan.
The left right.
Yeah, I would prefer to do left right. And Shikhar also has done well in the last ICC tournament. He's got a couple of hundreds, if I'm not mistaken. I think he was also the man of the series and loves to play there. And he always has a backup feel that once you've done well in a certain place, done well in a certain tournament, you try and it kind of gives you an extra bit. And Shikhar has that. So I would go with Shikhar and Rohit. Rohit a little undercooked, but so is Bahana. So I would still go with Rohit. Every player, if you go back and try and really use the magnifying glass and see, there will be something or other with every player. But the challenge lies with the player as to how you overcome that. And he's someone, I think he's changed a lot from the last time what he's gone. And the person who I see today is a lot different. A lot different. And my only worry with Kohli is that, is he a little fatigued right now? Is he playing too much? That's the only concern. But the technique bit, I'm not really concerned. He's too good a player to actually have that problem going into the championship. I'm just hoping some of these older lads will give me the same kind of vintage batting. I'm looking forward to Gareth Bale, Dhoni doing something special. Because these guys have done exceedingly well for us in the past. And probably they've come at a point where it's the twilight zone for them. A couple of years left, at most, if they really do. But this is again going to be a big tournament for a couple of these guys. If something doesn't go as per plan, it could be probably the last outing. Well, I would stick with the new ball with Umesh and Bhuvi. Get maybe Bumrah at bowl in number three. Simply because the lengths that we spoke about earlier, Umesh and Bhuvi bowl the length which is a little more up.
Okay.
Bumrah tends to bowl a tad bit short. That's the only reason why I say Bumrah number three and these two guys to open with the new ball. But if they can get Bumrah to bowl that length, I wouldn't mind them opening because Bhuvi and Umesh both are outswingers.
Okay.
Bumrah is the one who brings it in. So I don't mind one being an in-swinger, one being an outswinger. But Bumrah being an in-swinger, if he can get that ball a little tad bit up, if just maybe a yard up,
okay,
then I would go with Bumrah and Bhuvi. Then I'll hold back Umesh. Yeah, but if it stays the way it is, I would go with Bhuvi and Umesh. This time of the year, the spinners might have a big role to play. Unless they start off with wickets which are very dry and they don't leave any grass, then at the end of the tournament you might have Jadeja and Ash coming into play. But if they're going to give a decent track, which I would think is what they should give because that's a strength again, a little bit of grass, if that happens then I don't think spinners really will have a big role to play as wicket takers. Probably as defenders, probably as guys who look after the middle overs, guys who don't give away too many to start with, guys who can choke them a little bit and then maybe get a fall short in and get a wicket. But I don't see them really spinning the ball and making that happen. I don't see that happen. Okay, so let's say who fight would he be thinking of? I would say Bhuvi, Bhuvi, Bumrah, Hardik, Jadeja, Ashwin, or could it be four seamers and one spinner?
Yep, I think it's pretty much.
Because you've got Dhoni who can bat and keep, you've got Jadeja who can bat.
Yeah.
So it shouldn't be a bad option to have five bowlers.